Inshallah, today we will continue with the tafsir. I'm not sure we're going to be able to finish all of Juz' Amma, but we will try. And we reach Surah Al-Fajr in Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. It is chapter 89, and it was also revealed in Mecca. And this chapter was also recommended by Prophet ﷺ to read Isha time for Sayyidina Mu'ad when he was reading long surahs. Prophet ﷺ told him not to test the people and to read shorter surahs like إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انْفَطَرَتْ like وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا like this chapter والفجر والآيالين عشر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر والليل إذا يسر هل في ذلك قسم لذي حجر. الله سبحانه وتعالى he swears by his signs, his creation, by فجر والفجر وليال عشر, by the dawn and by the ten nights. And ulama said that the ten nights are the 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. That in Sayyid al-Bukhari, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, the Prophet said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحَ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ فِيهِنَّ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ. That these 10 days, that there isn't a deed. The first 10 days, يعني, up till Arafah of up to Eid of the month of Dhul Hijjah, Eid al-Adha, that Prophet ﷺ said that these 10 days there isn't any days better for a person to do good deeds in order than these 10 days. And in the tafsir of Ibn Kathir, that these 10 days, according to Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, Sayyidina Zubayr, Sayyidina Mujahid, and so many, that it is confirmed that these are the 10 days that are being sworn about in this surah. وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ, and by that which is even and that which is odd. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَسْرِ, and by the night when it departs. يعني when the night, يسر, to walk, when the night leaves, means when the day comes. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَسْرِ, some tafsir say that وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَسْرِ, that the night, not when it departs, but as it is moving along. هَلْ فِي ذَلِكَ قَصَمٌ لِذِي حِجْرٍ, say, is what we have, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to, all these signs Allah swore with, is there, does it register with anyone? ذِي حِجْر means a person with, is this sufficient proof for anyone, these signs we just mentioned, the night, the 10 days, the dawn, anyone with mind, hijr, is this enough proof for them? أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ. Did you not see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did to the people of Ad? They were the rebellious, disobedient, arrogant deniers of his messenger. And they rejected, as the people of Sayyidina Muhammad said, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he destroyed the people of Ad, annihilated them, and made them legends to be spoken of, made them an example. يعني أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعْلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ, that the people of Ad used to be very strong. They were the descendants of Ad bin Iram bin Aus bin Sam bin Nuh. So this is after Sayyidina Nuh, not long after Sayyidina Nuh, the people of Ad. This was, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, they were the people of the Prophet Hud. Prophet Hud is buried now in Hadramaut in Yemen. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. And he was one of the first, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, if I'm not mistaken, one of the Arab prophets. There are four amongst the early Arab besides Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These people rejected and opposed him. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him and his people, and they were destroyed. Irama dhati al-imad means they erected pillars. They were strong people that built pillars. Irama dhati al-imad built their homes high above the ground. Allah sent upon them a wind for 7 nights and 8 days until they were all destroyed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in different surahs, the author is saying, he reminds the people of Ad that didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let you establish yourselves in the land, and he gave you good creation and power. Basta means he increased you with abilities. فَاذْكُرُوا أَلَىٰ اللَّهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفَهِمُونَ. Remember the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They denied their prophet and they were destroyed. So these their buildings, they built high on above the ground. They built pillars and they built high. They were the first people to do that. That at that time no one had built like this. الَّتِي لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ. No one was building like that before them. وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ. And the people of Thamud, they carved, الَّذِينَ جَابُوا, جَابُوا is from, like they made pockets inside the, from جَيْبَ, it's like when you make a pocket. Like these people had such ability that the people of Thamud, that they made their homes inside the rocks, and I think they can still be witnessed some of the relics, the remnants, if I'm not mistaken, in Saudi Arabia, at Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. وثمود الذين جابوا الصخرة بالواد. They made their homes. Sayyidina Ibn Abbas said that they carved the rocks and they hewed them. This was also said by Sayyidina Mujahid and Sayyidina Qatada. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. What is they hewed them? That they basically tore open the rocks and made homes inside them. Allah says, وَتَنْحِتُونَ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا فَرِهِينَ. And you open space inside of the mountains with great skills. They had this ability. وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ وَفِرْعَوْنَ ذِي الْأَوْتَادِ. And Fir'aun, Pharaoh, with his armies and soldiers. Awtad is armies and soldiers. They are the ones who enforced his command. And here it is said that one of the meaning of Awtad is that Fir'aun used to, when they disobeyed, he used to nail their hands and feet into pegs, into awtad of iron that he would hang them from. Wallahu a'lam. Alladhina taghaw fil bilad. They transgressed beyond the boundaries that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set for them. Fa aktharu fiha al-fasad. in the land. Yani they transgressed in their land and they spread too much corruption. Yani subhanallah, you know, one should reflect, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. For anyone who has tul al-amal, who thinks that this earth is going to last as is for a long time. Look, these people, for one or two vices, for disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for spreading corruption in the land, they were punished. Now, if you reflect upon the state of the world today and the amount of madness and corruption, and why are human beings walking as if we're going to be here forever? As if, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's wrath that He promised is not about to befall us. Something to be wary of, and for believers to tighten their belts and to try to do as much as we can, especially now we're in the last 10 days of Ramadan. And today is the 21st, and Laylatul Qadr is in these 10 days. Is Allah knows how long this world will last. People feel it in their bones, that the amount of corruption that human beings have brought upon this earth cannot be sustained, even scientifically. You know, the system of capitalism and completely few people taking advantage of so many resources is not sustainable. The amount of corruption that is being done to the earth biologically and environmentally cannot be sustained. The amount of greed and wars that has been done cannot be sustained. The moral corruption that is spread, and kufr, is asking for catastrophe. So why aren't we, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, taking ibrah? Why aren't we worried that time may befall us? As I read, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim was always saying, soon. We are waiting for Mahdi alayhi salam. So as one of the hadiths about Mahdi is that he will fill the earth with justice and goodness after it was filled with oppression and badness. So earth qualifies. Now the description that it's filled with injustice and badness. Just look at what's happening in the Middle East now, and look at the whole world is watching the genocide of a group of people that are without ability to defend themselves, and no one is saying, no one is able to do anything. 2 billion Muslims. What is this? This saying that Allah is happy with the Muslims? Allah is happy with us, that He's showing us our ajz completely? That Allah is happy with this earth, that it is burning now? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma afina, keep us on the straight path until we leave this dunya, inshaAllah. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَا بَتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه فيقول ربي أهانا كلا بل لا تكرمون اليتيم ولا تحضون على طعام المسكين وتأكلون التراث أكلا لما وتحبون المال حبا جما. Here these verses Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فأما الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه. If a person is afflicted by his Lord, some difficulty with some goodness, أكرمه, he honored him, he showers on him his favors, he would say, oh, my Lord, He honored me. وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ. So Allah, this is an important thing. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ. See, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tries, bala, tries you with favors, you say, Allah saying, the Quran is saying, you say, oh, Allah honored me. وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ. And if He tries you, فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ. He made you with limited resources, poor. فيقول ربي أهانا. He would say, oh, Allah humiliated me. My Lord humiliated me. Allah saying, no. بل لا تكرمون اليتيم. You are not seeing all the favors I am bestowing on you. and you look at, if I don't give you a favor, and you say, oh, Allah is humiliating me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing me. Allah is saying, no. What do you do yourself? بَلَّا تُكْرِمْ. You don't honor the orphan. وَلَا تَحَضُّونَ عَلَى طَعَمْ مِسْكِينَ. And you, when you see impoverished people, you don't try to help them and give them food. وَتَأْكُلُونَ التُّرَاثَ أَكْلًا لَمَّا. And you devour the inheritance. When someone leaves, you don't share it with poor people. You, everything for you. وَتَأْكُلُونَ التُّرَاثَ أَكْلًا لَمَّا. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. And you love wealth, so much wealth. Prophet ﷺ, you know, someone equated, what you love is what you worship. So Prophet ﷺ said, تَعُسَ عَبْدُ الدِّرْهَمْ تَعُسَ عَبْدُ الدِّنَارِ, that a person who worships the gold coin and the silver coin, تَعُس means bad, miserable he will be. And he called them عَبْد, servant, a slave of. So, وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. And now you see this. People worship their money, their wealth. They slave morning till evening, 7 days a week, to collect, knowing that it is temporary, they will have to leave it. But they do. And that is ibadah, that is worship. If we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet, we will be invested in that way. كَلَّا إِذَا دُكَّتِ الْأَرْضُ دَكَّا. If this earth is demolished, flattened, وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا. And when your Lord, when people are called for judgment and your Lord comes for the, meaning the judgment, when وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ means when Rabbuka is present for judging his creatures. And this is after the intercession of Prophet ﷺ. Prophet ﷺ will intercede before the judgment begins when people will be waiting for judgment. It is said it will be 1,000 years of Allah's years in very difficult conditions, and then they will go to Prophet ﷺ, they will go to all the prophets, and all of them will say, no, I cannot stand in my Lord's presence. Allah has never been this angry. And Sayyidina Muhammad will say, أنا لها. He will say, this is for me. This station of intercession is for me, and he will intercede. And جِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ. And heaven and hell will be brought. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, يُؤْتَى بِجَهَنَّمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَهَا 70,000 زِمَامٍ مَعْ كُلِّ زِمَامٍ 70,000 مَلَكٍ يَجُرُّونَ. The Prophet ﷺ said that Jahannam will be brought close to, in front of the people, near to them. It will have 70,000 zimam, means rope, and every rope will have 70,000 angels, and they will be bringing it. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَ. On that day, when it's too late, people will remember. People will remember their deeds, remember how they wasted their lives. They will remember how they, all the bad choices they've made, but it's too late. وَأَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَ. It will not benefit at that time to remember. فَيَوْمَئِذٍ لَا يُعَذِّبُ عَذَابَهُ أَحَدٌ وَلَا يُثِقُ وَثَاقَهُ أَحَدٌ. On that day, none has the ability to punish and will punish. None has the qudra that can severely punish than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will decree the punishment on that day. وَلَا يُوثِقُ وَثَاقَهُ أَحَدٌ. And none will bind as he will bind, meaning there's no one who is more severely punished and bound than those the Zabaniyah punish, and the Zabaniyah punish. This is Zabaniyah is the angels that are taking care of the hell. That at that time, no one punishes like them, and no one ties the disbelievers like them. This is for the criminals and the wrongdoers among the creation. But for the good ones, for the pure souls, the good servants, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Ya ayyatuha an-nafsul mutma'inna, O tranquil soul. And Quran mentions three types of nafs, of souls. Nafsul ammara, the self that orders, that wants you to do bad things. Nafsul mulhama, Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad, lawama, nafsul lawama. That nafsul lawama mentioned in the Quran means the nafs that it's like your conscience. Why did you do that? Do good, don't do bad. That's the nafsul mulhama. And a nafsul mutma'inna is when a nafs that becomes satisfied, content, happy in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as its Lord, and Allah is happy with that self. That self, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if people attain that level of self, of a nafsul mutma'inna, you will be called on Judgment Day. Ya ayyatuha nafsul mutma'inna, O tranquil self, or content self, satisfied self, enlightened self, whatever you want to call it, come back to your Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls it back to himself, radiya, content, happy, pleased, mardiya, well-pleasing, means Allah is pleased with you. فَادْخُلِي فِي عِبَادِي, enter into my true servants, my good servants, into their ranks. وَادْخُلِي جَنَّتِي, and enter into my heaven. رَزَقَنَ اللَّهُ. When we recite this, we say, Ya Rabbi, grant us to be from these people, from أصحاب النفس المطمئنة. Grant us to reach, grant us to purify our egos, our nafs, from nafs al-ammara to an-nafs al-mutma'inna, to become in this dunya before we leave, so that we may be called on Judgment Day, Ya ayyatuha an-nafs al-mutma'inna, irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan mardiyya. Allah. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas said that this ayah was revealed while Sayyidina Abu Bakr was sitting with the Prophet. Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So he said, O Messenger of Allah, there is nothing better than this. So when Sayyidina Abu Bakr heard these verses, Ya ayyatuha an-nafsu al-mutma'inna, irji'i, O tranquil self, O happy self, content self, Sayyidina Abu Bakr said, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, There must be nothing better than this, to be called by Allah, or to come into His heavens, to be pleased with Allah, for Allah to be pleased with you. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Sayyidina Abu Bakr, "Amma innahu sayuqalu laka hadha." This will, he said, for you, to Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, they will say, this will be said to you. You are from the people who will say, Ya ayyatuha an-nafsu al-mutma'inna. Allahumma arzuqna husna al-khatima ma'al-ladhina an'amta alayhim min an-nabiyyina wa s-siddiqina wa s-shuhada'i wa s-salihin. وحسن أولئك رفيقا. And thank you very much. Inshallah, we'll continue tomorrow. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Anyone who said salam, I know people are joining us from everywhere. Sister Farah from Sri Lanka, from Connecticut, the Columbus, from the UK, Shumaila, I think, and Sister Rajia, Sister Judith from Canada, from Quebec, some from Indonesia, wherever you are, inshallah. Allah grant us to witness Laylatul Qadr. Keep us in your dua. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.